Are you ready?
Wow.
You want to teach me how to dance?
Nous avons dans le pilou.
I'm here to learn how to do your airway dance.
Yeah.
What are we? What? How do you do?
You do like one like this.
Yeah. Wait. So
like this.
Like this. As if I'm going to fly.
Yeah. You're going to fly there.
What about my leg? Yeah, are they?
Just like this.
Uh-huh,
right?
Okay.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Then we start like this.
Yeah. And so wait, at what point do you take your leg? Welcome in airway.
Wizzo.
So tell my people Wizzo right now.
Wizzo.
Okay, so
Wizzo.
So guys, hi, welcome to my YouTube channel. We are here to prepare Gary. We are here to find out how Gary is made. And they are the wonderful people who are going to be teaching me how to prepare Gary. I want you to come with me, enjoy this whole vibe, and come on. The whole Gary process, where are we starting from?
We are starting from how we are going to put the cassava.
Okay.
We come and peel it in the house.
Okay.
When we put the cassava, we need the people who come and help you because we peel it one by one.
Okay.
Other people come to help you. I'm not even peeling it. You need to wash it.
Okay.
You wash it, finish. Then you call the machine. The machine come and grind it for you. After that, you put it under the firewood.
Okay.
After that, you'll be pressing it small, pressing it. All of the water will come out inside and you remove it again.
So that means that you are going to show me how this is done.
We are going to show you everything.
So we are going to do it.
We are going to do it.
Even when I sick like this small, eh?
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, give me that. Yeah. Another yeah. Okay, let's go and prepare the Gary. Okay. We are going to prepare Gary. What is the name of this town?
Adalekwe.
Adalekwe?
Yeah, Adalekwe.
But what is that when you guys are mentioning the name of the town, you stretch your hand like this, Adalekwe?
But we have some passion on it.
Yeah.
We are proud of our town.
You are proud of your town, yeah. So it's Adalekwe.
Adalekwe.
Yeah. Okay, all right. I like your town, it's quiet. I'm the only person making noise right now.
No.
Yeah.
There are a lot of people make noise in the town.
Yeah, but today I'm the only person making the noise.
Yeah.
Okay. So which direction are we going?
We are going to the direction.
We are going over there.
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Nde.
So when I say Nde, then you say what?
Nde. Efema.
Huh?
Efema.
Efema.
Edo.
What do my talk?
Eh?
What do my talk?
Eh?
Only.
Anyway, so.
What do my talk?
Eh?
Amanda. Only. Bishop.
Eli.
What
do
you? Amanda.
Only.
Dejo.
Amanda.
Ufo.
If
I
was asking your daughter,
your wife.
Hey!
Me phone. Charlie, I know how to speak small now. When you see me in town, just say me phone. I'll say me phone. Anyway, so.
Yeah.
We peel the cassava. Is there a special way of peeling? Do you feel like the way you peel them?
You can peel at least two.
Okay, because I know how to peel.
Yeah, if you drop in that way, you start like this.
Oh, but won't you get, you finish a lot of the flesh from it by the time you finish?
Yeah, you start like that.
Yeah. Hey,
you're doing it.
By the way, I'm moving slow there. By the time I finish, then we'll leave here tomorrow.
No, you finish right now.
We'll finish right now,
Yeah.
Okay.
Small, you'll be on it small, then you finish.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So, how long has this town been doing cassava? What's the name, Gary?
Gary. Mm-hmm. And many times, it keep long because they started this thing not today.
Not today, eh?
Yeah, they started this thing not today.
It's uncountable.
Wow. But, so when you do the Gary, what happens to the gari? What do you use the gari for?
The gari sometimes they used to do biscuits, they used to do akponovi.
Biscuits,
yeah. Hey. And akponovi, all the same bread, everything. They used to do it.
They use gari to mismatch it.
Okay, and when you put do the gari, where does it end up? Is it that somebody comes to the town to buy the gari and send it to?
There was a customer.
There's a customer. Mm. Okay.
She will come and buy it here.
Okay.
And send it to
other places.
Okay. All right.
At this point, after we finish peeling the cassava, then what will we do next?
You wash it.
Okay.
With water.
Okay.
After that, you call the machine people to come and grind it for you.
Ah, there's a special people who come to grind it.
Grind it.
Oh, okay. So you can't pound it in there.
You can't pound it.
Water.
No.
Pounding is like fufu.
Fufu. Ah. That means you cook it before you pound it.
Oh. But where are the ewes originally from?
Ngote.
Eh?
Ngote.
Noche.
Noche.
You can call it like that. Noche.
Noche.
Yeah.
Okay. Noche.
So you are from Noche before.
Before you migrated to Gvota region.
Mm.
Oh, okay. That's nice information. And Noche, is it in Ghana? Is it in Ghana or something? Where is that
place? Not in Ghana. It's like our forefathers' place. Where our forefathers live.
Okay. Alright, so this is the peeling process. After this, the cassava is going to be washed and then taken to the machine where we are going to grind it, the milling machine, where they will mill this whole cassava into soft. It's not going to be powdered because it's still watery though. So after we take it from the machine, then we'll dry the water out, right?
Yeah,
we'll squeeze the water out.
Yeah.
Okay, so watch out for that. Just been drying the cassava dough and we brought it here. Now, what is the name of this stage?
The stage, we are going to stretch it so that it will come out.
Okay.
So we will take some rubbish on it and throw it away.
Okay.
There's a lot of rubbish is on it.
Uh-huh.
So when you stretch it like this, the rubbish will come, then we throw it away.
Okay.
Or that one, sometimes we not throw it away. We go to the machine again, the machine will grind it again.
Okay.
We need to cook apple. Apple again.
Ah, so uh-huh. You...
Or sometimes we beat goats, the goat will eat it.
Okay.
Sometimes chicken will eat it.
Right,
uh-huh.
right. So what we are about to do is to... what is the name of this?
Agbaje, how do you call it? And
No, in the local language, what's the name?
The local... Agbaje.
Agbaje. So we are about to pass the dough over the agbaje.
Agbaje.
Just for us to have the chaff out, the rest of it that we don't want. They say it can either be used for akple.
Yeah.
Is it akple or akple?
Akple. Yeah.
Hey. Their language, their matango. Akple.
Akple.
So you use it to cook akple,
or you give to goats and chicken, don't eat it.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
That's what you do.
Okay. All right, so right now, how do you go about this?
We are going to do it like this.
Okay.
Small,
eh?
Yeah, it will be going.
Okay.
It's going.
When you are doing it, it's coming.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. It will be like this.
Okay. How long can this process take?
Sometimes, if the thing is fast,
yes,
it will take like 2 minutes.
Oh,
then you finish
okay.
5 minutes, you finish.
Oh, okay. Uh-huh. But what happens if you don't use this? After you dry the dough and you just go straight up and start putting it on the fire.
The reason we do like this, when we don't do like this, it won't be nice.
It won't be nice.
It won't be nice.
Oh,
that's why we need to come out the rubbish inside before we do it.
So the fiber and the tuber and everything.
Yeah, we need to come out it inside.
Oh, okay. Remove
it inside before, so that when you do it, it will be nice for everybody to see.
For everybody to eat.
Yeah. Okay.
So we are doing it just to get the fiber out.
Yeah.
Sometimes the fiber is too big for eating, so this is going to sieve it, and this serve more as a sieve, so we have to keep doing it till everything goes down, and then the rest of the residues or the fiber we'll give it to the goat or use it to cook. Akple, say akple.
Akple.
Akple. Akple.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you have any company that partner with you guys so that you do gari for them, or tell me a little bit about the gari business here?
And during some times ago, we have some people came here, they have some gari factory, so they come and bought gari and they put inside the sack, small, they send it outside. But I do sometimes, they are no more coming again, but we have many people, they will come here, come and buy the gari. Okay. They send to Mavikmasi, they send to Accra, people buy it in their store, that's what we do here.
Oh.
And so they will have your own customer, the customer will come and buy the gari for you, and they will take it out.
But do you have more? Oh, that's all. How much is one bag of gari here?
We have 10 CD.
You have what?
10 CD.
10 CD for a bag of gari?
No, we have the some lunka.
Ah, okay. Uh-huh.
Lunka to fetch it for you.
Okay.
Sell it for you, we have 10 CD.
Okay, but a whole bag, a whole sack, how much is it?
Sometimes the cost of gari reduce, sometimes it go up. So the bag of the gari, number 4, sometimes like 500 plus CD. Or 600 CD plus.
Oh, okay.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but you guys, you are making money. And should I stop my work and come and join you?
Oh, if you come and join us, you can come and do it
so that you hire me full time and then I'll be here.
Yeah, but before you start doing this business, you suffer a lot for doing, because going to the farm is difficult.
Oh, but if you can do it, I can also do it.
You can also do it.
Yeah.
When you learn, you will do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What is the most difficult part about farming?
That about the farming, when you go to the farm.
Uh huh.
The time that you started planting the cassava stick, it's difficult.
When
you finish, there are some grasses will be coming, you need to dig it.
Okay.
Small, we use medicine. But if you know to do the medicine too, you're going to kill them.
Okay.
Kill the cassava. So you need to do in some way that the medicine will not touch the cassava sticks, right? It will die. So when you finish that, you'll be waiting for sometimes you have to go and clean it small, removing the grasses inside, inside, so that it will be nice. But if you refuse to remove the grasses inside, that means it won't work well. It won't work well, because when you pull it, it will come in small.
Oh.
But when you pull it, when you remove the grasses, it will be big.
Okay.
It will be big. The cassava will be big small. But after that, you will pull it. Before you carry it from the farm to the house, it's somehow difficult small. But during some times ago, we started using motoka. Again, bring it to the house. That's what we do.
Oh, okay. So this is the chaff that we were trying to get rid of, and it is all here. This is what is used for our clean sometimes, or they feed the animals with it. And but every part of the cassava at this stage is useful. Do you guys eat the cassava leaf here?
Yeah, yeah.
You eat the cassava leaf?
Yeah, we eat it here.
The leaf?
The leaves. Sometimes I used to cook soup, you eat.
You use it for soup?
Soup.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a good medicine.
Good medicine.
It's a medicine.
Okay.
So if you're eating it, you'll be strong.
Immune system.
Okay.
Now that we are done with the sieving process, what next?
After this, then you put this inside the medicine.
The fire. Okay. So from here, we are going to start putting it on the fire and then see how the whole process goes. Mixing the gari. How do you term this? Mixing of the gari. Or should we call it roasting gari?
We are roasting the gari.
Okay, so now we are roasting the gari, and it's not easy. A lot of smoke. So when the fire is too much like this, then it starts becoming hard.
It's hard. It starts becoming hard.
Okay. So we have to use light fire.
So if it's coming hard like this, let me teach you how to do it. See? If it comes under this.
Now it's turning into fufu.
But you need to do like this. You see, I'm doing it. Do like this.
Right now, it's selling to Eba. You know Eba?
Yeah.
But it's selling to Eba.
No, no, it's okay.
I don't know. It's boiling on this time.
So how long can the process like this take? The roasting process.
The roasting process.
Yes.
Okay. Sometimes it depends how the minute as well as the thing.
Okay.
Before you finish everything Sunday, then everything finish. So Monday you take the market. But right now, if I do like this, it depends how the fire is coming. If the fire is fast,
yeah,
it will be. It will not take much time before you finish.
Oh, uh-huh. I see. Is
yeah.
I'm tired. Yeah. But like my whole mazu, you can see that my mazu is
green. Yeah, it's green.
So guys, this is how gari is made. If you've seen gari before, you should know that it's like the whole process is not easy. Mm-hmm. My arms are all paining me, my hand, my mazu is everywhere. And I'm so amazed how you people are able to stand by this fire or sit by this fire and then roast the gari. It's a lot of work. What made you to also join the whole gari making process?
Because it's our forefathers started doing it from the beginning, so and after which we are grown up, we learn it. It's a work that we are doing here. So if you not do this work, that means we can not do any work. Not get any work here.
Okay. Right. But do you have machines that do the gari like this, or it always has to be with your hand?
Only hand. We don't have any machine.
Okay.
To do like this.
So now the gari as sport is now becoming fine gari.
Yeah.
But I know some people have yellow gari.
Yeah.
I don't know. Have you ever seen the yellow gari?
I've seen it before.
Okay. So what accounts for that? What makes the gari
to be yellow? We use palm nut oil. Palm nut oil to do it.
So they add palm nut oil.
Or palm nut oil. Okay. To the addition. So if you don't know how to do it, you're going to do the bad one. See, it's something that you will learn before you do it. So can people sometimes? Some people send it. The sample colors that they should do like that. Do like that for my students. They like in that way, so we do it like that. With palm nut oil, and we send it to them.
So it's not butter or something like that?
No, it's not butter. It's palm nut oil.
Oh, okay. So whenever you see the yellow gari, that means that they added palm nut oil to it. At what stage do you add the palm nut oil? Is it at this stage? Or
at this stage. When, if you are going to put it under the block, you miss it. When you grind it finish, you mix it with the palm nut oil before you put it under the stone.
Okay. But how many types of gari do we have?
Sometimes let me think that we have 3 types of gari.
We have 3 types of gari. Okay.
You know, sometimes some of the gari we use coconut do it.
Okay.
It's very sweet. When you use coconut do it, it's very sweet.
But is it the coconut oil or the coconut?
Coconuts.
Ah.
The hard one.
Yes. They grind it.
They grind it.
And then the gari.
The gilimi gari. If you eat it, it's very nice. It's like you are eating milk.
Guys, have you ever seen coconut gari before? It's my first time coming to hear about it. Do you know somewhere that they process some?
That they process here.
Yeah.
When you send it, that they process, they'll do it for here.
So if I ask them to do it today,
they'll do it when they get the coconuts, they'll do it today.
Yeah. So, but is there some that I can taste?
Please.
Is there some that I can taste? Some of the
coconuts? Yeah.
I'll get some to taste.
Yeah.
Okay. So Foster, how do you know that the gari is ready?
Okay. The time you started doing it, you can see that everything mixed together.
Yes.
In the first stage.
Yes. It's
by the second stage, when you see that it's ready, that means all of them is separate.
It's separate.
It's separate one by one.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. It will come and try before you know that it has finished.
So right now it's wet.
It's wet.
But yeah, it's dry.
It is dry.
Woo!
Yeah. That's how we do it.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what do you eat gari with?
Sometimes gari, we eat it with coconuts.
Coconuts?
And we used to do soupries.
Okay, soupries.
We used to do gariba.
Gariba.
Eba.
Eba.
We used to do that. Oh, we need to do many things.
So this is gari when it is ready. And at this point, you can see how it's coming together. Unlike this, where it's still stuffy or thick. This is still wet.
You can see that it's wet. So if you are even dropping it, but with this, you see how it comes out.
So every little corner I've gone into, I've seen that everyone is doing their own little gari in their own space. I mean, it is very beautiful. I like the fact that everyone is trying to get involved with the whole gari business. But are you guys open to collaborate with other people in case you want to set up a factory or company here?
Yes.
You are open.
We allow that everybody that will come and set company here, yeah. We allow them to come and set company here.
Okay.
And then we do the gari for him so that it can be taken away.
Okay.
So that our tiredness must be reduced more.
Right. So for those of you who are looking forward to moving to Ghana or doing business in Ghana, this is a perfect avenue or opportunity for you. They have a whole lot of gari processing that happens here, but how to process it that will make their work easy. Do you guys have a machine that does everything or you have to manually do it?
Sometimes our machine to do it, sometimes we manually do it in ourselves.
Okay. Mm-hmm. But do you guys have challenge? Is there any challenge that you face with the whole gari processing?
Yeah, we face more challenges on it.
Okay, like what? Challenge.
Like right now you're roasting gari before rice, it's hot like this.
Yes.
If you are roasting it, your hand will be paining you.
Yes, I felt that when I was roasting it,
your hand will be paining you.
Okay.
Sometimes when you finish, your hand cry to it too. It will come be hard. Unless you use hot water, clean your hand before it can be so small.
Okay.
That's the challenge we are facing.
Okay. So I mean, this is a perfect way of investing and helping the community. Gari is one major food that is consumed around West Africa, Nigeria, Ghana, Liberia, Ivory Coast, everywhere they know gari because cassava is a big deal here. So you can look into doing this and then export gari to other parts of the world because we have Africans living everywhere in this world and they need gari, you know. So I've told you, and so in case someone wants to be of help or be in partnership, how can they reach you guys?
Okay, if the person wants to reach us or 2 weeks, they can call us through our number.
Okay. Can you mention that number?
I can mention my number.
Okay, mention your number.
Okay,
right now.
My number is 0243.
Okay.
363840.
Do you want to sing with it?
0243 363840.
You heard it for yourself. So reach out to him. He is one of the tall guy in the community that helps with the communication, and he's a very nice person. He has helped us a lot, and that is why I'm giving his information to you guys, so that in case you have any plans of investing, you will reach out to him. So guys, until I see you in the next video, say bye for now. Bye.